Good morning. My name is Mia Malhotra, and I've been a part of St. Paul's since 2017. My husband Mark was baptized here, and my daughters Anna and Alice are two very joyful members of the choir school. We're so grateful to have found our spiritual home at St. Paul's. I was raised in an evangelical home by parents who served as missionaries in Laos and Thailand, and Mark grew up in a mixed-race family with Hindu, agnostic, and Catholic grandparents, so when it came time for us to discover our unique spiritual identity as a couple, and later as a family, the obvious choice eluded us. Eventually, however, we discovered the embrace of the Episcopal Church, its tradition of liturgical prayer, intellectual inquiry, and of course, its music. For my very first Sunday here, I've been blessed by St. Paul's music ministry. I love the sound of our Skinner organ, the intricate architecture of its voice, its range of color and tone. I love singing in the choir each week and the way Dr. Matthews brings the liturgical year alive through a cycle of hymns and anthems, which we share in the common labor of our voices. In her memoir about living among Benedictine monks, the poet Kathleen Norris says, "For me, participating in monastic lectio has meant rediscovering a religion that consists not so much of ideas or doctrines, but of song and breath. It's encountering the words of scripture in such a way that they become as alive as the people around me. And this is how I feel about music at St. Paul's. Through it, God's life comes alive in me. It's humbling to offer up something as human and elemental as breath, but to do this together, lifting our voices in song, makes the human feel more heavenly, and maybe the heavenly a little more human. Worshiping here, I've learned so much about the act of listening. To music, yes, but also to space. How sometimes it feels like the church itself is speaking as the organ's pedal tones reverberate through the building. How there's a quickening in my soul when I'm moved by the gentle cadence of chant at evensong or the Magnificat's haunting melodic lines. Through music, I'm invited each week to enter into living, breathing relationship with the word, which, like Nora says, is like falling in love. Because you don't enter into it knowing the depths. It's a relationship you live with until you begin to understand it. And I also wanted to say, because today happens to be our monthly evensong, I do hope that you will come and listen with me for what might flutter into life in your own interior, how God's life might begin to stir, enveloping us in the living, lived-in poem of relation with one another, creation, and with the Spirit. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.